Well, my name is Adrian Contreras, and I am a graduate student here at UCSF in the lab of Dr. Ruggero. And what the lab studies overall is looking into the molecular mechanisms of how cancer arises. And we're looking into how the cells make proteins. And when the process of how the cells make proteins gets out of control, we're looking into how that can cause cancer and how can cancer cells use that in their advantage to, you know, grow more, basically. I actually grew up in Mexico. It's funny as I look back because I never got a lot of exposure to science when I was growing up. Basically, my dad, he's a businessman. My mom is also a businesswoman. My mom went only to high school, and my dad, he got kicked out of high school. So I grew up just always having this interest and curiosity about how things work. And that, I guess, developed as I grew up, and it's kind of have been like my driving force to you know, be where I am right now. I studied microbiology when I was in college, and I always have a fascination on microbes and, you know, also all the things that we humans use microbes for, right? But then as I, you know, transitioned my studies and got here to do a PhD, I decided to do something different from microbes. I decided to, you know, I became very interested in the human disease and from the point of view of cancer. We're looking into lymphoma, so blood cancers. We're also looking into congenital disorders.
Yes, these are basically cancer cells, and what you can see is cancer cells have this proclivity to move a lot.
Everybody in our lab have, you know, a specific question that we're trying to address, and the process of how cancer arises is fascinating to me because, you know, all the cells in our body have only this finite or limited ability to grow. And, you know, they are under a lot of, you know, controls to like stop growing if they touch other neighboring cells. You know, they all have this program inside of them to, let's say, behave normally. People always seen cancer cells as just being out of control, just want to grow like crazy. But we actually have been finding out that they do actually have their own set of rules.
This is the protein being lost and the protein being overexpressed in cancer cells.
Okay.
It's really interesting because you basically have, you know, a set of questions and you're thinking about what experiments to do to address that question. So every day you're, you know, doing experiments, you are analyzing the results and thinking about, okay, what is this telling me? Because a cell cannot talk to you and say, hey, I have cancer because this happened and this was wrong. And so you basically have to interpret. It's like an investigator, you know, that goes to a crime scene. He looks up all the evidence and he tries to figure out what happened. Basically the same thing is happening here. So you look at the data, you know, you talk to people. That's something that that happens also in a day-to-day basis. You know, I talk to my mentor, Davide, you know, about my results.
Good. Yeah. Awesome, all right.
You're always thinking about different things to do, different experiments, to target different questions. So you're never doing the same thing. You're always thinking what to do next. Yeah, a lot of the times experiments don't work and that's very disappointing, but you also have to, you learn how to deal with failure. And, but you also get very excited when things work. And that also motivates you to, you know, keep going, keep answering the next question. So my hopes and dreams are that one day I can impact the life of people through my science. I hope to be a good scientist, which I'm getting good preparation here in the lab of Dr. Ruggero. And I hope that what I end up doing after this will directly contribute to you know, getting treatment for people. And basically improving the life of people that have cancer.